What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to load a schematic into WorldEdit. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Building in Minecraft is time-consuming, especially if you're trying to create a large spawn or hub for your server. And this is amplified if you're wanting to add details and decorations afterwards. But if you aren't too creative, or if you just found a build online that you like, you can upload pre-made structures into your world with the WorldEdit plugin and mod. You can also save any building you already have to transfer them to a new world or server. There are both plugin and mod versions of WorldEdit, meaning you can use this on almost any server type. For Spigot or paper servers, head to the WorldEdit on Bucket's website, and near the top of the page, press the Files tab. Find your desired version and click the Download button, and then save this file somewhere easily accessible on your computer. For Forge and Fabric, head to WorldEdit on CurseForge and press the Files tab at the top. From here, find your desired game version and select it, and then save the file on your computer somewhere easy to get to. Whichever server version you're using, make sure the game file section of the panel has the supported type selected to match the version that you downloaded. For a plugin setup, head towards your Apex server panel, stop the server, and click FTP file access near the top left. Log in, and then find and select the plugins directory, and on the next page, click upload, and then you can drag and drop the file into the upload area, and once it reaches 100%, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel and restart the server. For a mod setup, head towards your server panel, stop the server, and then click on FTP file access, log in, and then find and enter the mods directory, and then press upload. Drag and drop the files into the upload area, and once it's 100% uploaded, you can return to the main server panel and restart the server. For mods, you're also going to have to download this mod client side, so if you need to know how to do that, we will have a tutorial listed down below. Now, to find schematics to use, you can use two different options. If you're looking for a pre-made structure by other players, then you're going to have to search online. Some of these sites require a registered account to download files, like Minecraft Schematics, but there are also free and safe websites to use as well. Head to the Schematics section on Planet Minecraft, and then find and select your desired map or schematic. Once you find that, press the Download Schematic button on the right, and then save this file on your computer for later. In some cases, the files are going to be zipped into a single document. Otherwise, you should see schematic or schem files after downloading them from Planet Minecraft. You can also save existing structures into your Minecraft server to transfer into other worlds. If these structures are on a single-player world, you'll have to install Forge or Fabric on the client side with the mod version of WorldEdit. Enter your server or single-player world and then use the wand command. Find your desired structure to make it a schematic, and once it's found, place two blocks outside of it for the copying process. This will be done at its opposite corners, with one near ground level and the other in the sky above the structure. Head towards the first block and left-click while holding the wand, and then do the same for the second position, but right-click instead. After that, use the copy command so the build is in your in-game clipboard, and then run the schematic save name command to save the structure in a file. Single player worlds will store these schematic files in your local game directory. This is done by heading to the Installations tab in your Minecraft launcher, and then clicking the folder icon on your modded profile. After that, head towards the config WorldEdit directory to view the schematics folder containing your structures. Any schematics saved on the server will be found in specific files depending on the game version you're using, which we will go over a bit later. After creating your schematics, either in your server or through single player, using them is the next step. The pathways to upload schematics changes if you're using spigot or paper, or Forge or Fabric, so make sure you're following the right pathways. Head towards your FTP file access from the main server panel, log in, and then head to the correct schematic folder in your FTP panel. For the plugin version, you're going to go to Plugins, WorldEdit, and Schematics. And in the mod version, you're going to go to Config, WorldEdit, and then Schematics. Once you enter this pathway, press Upload in the top left corner, and then you can drag and drop your schematic or schem files into the upload area. Wait for this to reach 100%, and then you can return to the main panel and restart the server. Once you have those saved, loading the schematic in your world is pretty quick and easy, since it only involves a few commands. Join your server and run the wand command if you don't have the tool already. Afterwards, find a suitable location for a desired schematic, and once you find this spot, you can use the schem load name command without the file type at the end. When you're ready, use the paste command to generate the structure at the in-game location. If you accidentally paste your schematic in the wrong location, or if it isn't placed correctly, then you can use the undo command. You can also use paste negative A for this process, which will remove air blocks when appearing in-game. There are other commands to try out too, which we recommend exploring if you're still having issues with loading the schematics properly. If WorldEdit isn't working, the first thing you're going to want to check is that you followed the correct process for either the plugin or the mod version, and that you have the matching game version to whichever one you chose. If you do the mod version, make sure you also have WorldEdit installed on the client side, which we do have a guide to that will be linked down below. If the schematics aren't loading, this might be due to the structure exceeding the currently used Minecraft version, leading to incompatibility problems. It could also be that the schematic wasn't saved properly by the creator. Lastly, it could just be that the schematic is too large for the game or server to handle. To fix this, you could try to use the FA plugin or mod instead for better optimization. Whether you're wanting to build your own world in your server, or if you just found a cool structure online that you think would make a great addition, using WorldEdit is the perfect way to easily transfer structures over in minutes, so you can set up your server way quicker than building everything yourself. That's all for this one, and as always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.